Hello everybody, my name is Gustavo from copahost.com web hosting. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install AlmaLinux version 9 using VirtualBox in your Windows operating system. Actually, AlmaLinux is a new version of the CentOS Linux. It's just like a fork from the CentOS. AlmaLinux is a very complete operating system. It's been the default standard for the new cPanel versions. And the industry is starting to use it more and more right now. It's a very nice operating system, very stable and very reliable. So first of all, you have to download the VirtualBox. Let me show you how to do that. You have to go to the VirtualBox website here. Just go to virtualbox.org. And now you have to click download. As I have already downloaded the VirtualBox in my PC, I'm going to skip the installation process. So just click download and then choose the version of your operating system. For instance, I'm going to use as Windows here. Okay. Okay. So let's first of all open the VirtualBox. Just a comment, in this channel we have videos with other installations using the VirtualBox manager with other versions, for instance CentOS and Ubuntu. You can just browse the channel for other similar videos of Linux installations using the VirtualBox manager in Windows operating system. Okay, so first of all we have to download the AlmaLinux. We have to go to the website almalinux.org. This is the AlmaLinux website. Let's click download. Okay, we're going to choose the version 9, which is the newer version as of today. Now here you choose the mirror. I'm choosing this version because it's the most complete version of the AlmaLinux. You can either choose this DVD ISO or else this latest DVD ISO. They are pretty the same. So, just click here to download. First of all, you have to create a new virtual machine in VirtualBox. So let's click this blue icon, new. Okay, I'm going to give the name as AlmaLinux. Now I'm going to click expert mode so that I can choose more options. Let's name it AlmaLinux. Okay, first of all, we have to choose the memory amount. I'm going to place just 10 gigabytes of memory here. I'm going to click create to create the virtual machine. Here we have to choose the total storage size of our virtual machine. I recommend at least 15 gigabytes so that you are safe and have plenty of space to work. So I'm going to slide here until 15 gigabytes. Now I'm going to click create. Okay, so our virtual machine is created, it's almost ready. These are the parameters of the virtual machine, the space, the interfaces we have. Now there is a trick. We have to get the ISO downloaded with the AlmaLinux installation and we have to attach as a virtual DVD in our virtual machine. That's pretty much just like as we had a physical DVD and inserted in the drive of a physical PC. But of course, as we are working with a VirtualBox virtualization, there is no need to have a physical DVD. We can just make everything virtual. So first of all, I'm going to click here, settings. Now I'm going to click storage. Now click this small icon where it's empty. Now this other blue icon here, just click it. Now we have to click choose create a virtual optical disk. Okay, now I have to add the downloaded ISO of the AlmaLinux. So just click add here. I'm going to choose this AlmaLinux 9 version. I have other Linux versions, but in this video I'm going to show how to install AlmaLinux. Okay, just click open here. Okay, now we have added the virtual disk to the container, to the virtual machine. So just click choose. Okay, now you can see the disk is set up, is inserted. Now click OK. Okay, perfect. So it will show here in controller IDE, optical drive, AlmaLinux 9, as I explained, just like if you had a physical disk inserted in a PC. OK, Okay, so now let's click start to boot the virtual server. Okay, now we have to click start to boot the operating system, to boot the installation of the AlmaLinux. Let's click start here. Okay, so this is the first AlmaLinux installation. It's pretty similar to the CentOS. In this first screen, you have to use the keyboard. I'm going to choose the install AlmaLinux 9. Just make it white and hit enter with your keyboard. Let's wait until it boots. It may take a few moments. In VirtualBox, you can increase the number of CPUs of your virtual machine so that it's faster. Okay, in my example, I have set 2 CPUs, which is my default for every created virtual machine. Okay, so this is the first screen of the installation. AlmaLinux just have the graphical version of the installation, just like CentOS. First of all, I'm going to choose English as the default language of this Linux. So just choose English and click continue. Okay, in this default screen of the installation, we have to do basically 2 things. First of all, we have to set the root password. I'm going to click here, root password. Now just set the root password. The root password is the administration login of your operating system. It's the very more powerful user of Linux. So I'm going to choose the password. Just write down this password. If you lose it, I'm afraid you have to reinstall the AlmaLinux. Okay, so I have set my root password and click done. It will ask to click done again to confirm. So let's click again done. Okay, the second thing we have to do is to select the installation destination. Right here, I'm going to keep the automatic configuration here on storage configuration. As you said, automatic is just a default partitioning system. I don't see any need for you to change the partitioning right now. If you are on a production server, in a powerful server, okay, that may be important for you to make a custom partitioning, but in this video, I'm going to leave everything easier. So let's click done here. Okay, so as you can note, the red alert in the root password disappeared and the red alert in the installation destination just disappeared. What you can do, you can just, if you wish, it's not mandatory, you just can click on software selection, and here you can choose how you can and here you can choose how you're going to install this operating system. I'm going to leave the default, having the server with the graphical interface GUI. In the right, you can choose which services you wish to install, just like the FTP, a mail server. Okay, if you wish only the text mode of the Linux, for instance, to install cPanel or any specific application, you might go here on a server without a GUI. But in this sample, I'm going to use the complete version with the GUI. Just click done again. Okay, so now I'm going to click begin installation so that the installation starts. Okay, it's just copying and configuring everything. This process may take several minutes. You have to be patient. In this video, we're going to speed things up so that we can save your time. But this is the process of the installation. So, now the installation is completed after a few minutes. Right now, what we have to do is click Reboot System, this blue button here. Now, Linux is just shutting down the applications. It's now loading the operating system we have just installed. Okay, so this is the Welcome AlmaLinux 9 screen. This is the very first introduction screen of the Linux. Okay, what you have to do now is scroll a little down. You will see this blue button to start setup. So just click here. Okay, AlmaLinux will ask you to configure some things. I will leave everything as default. Just click next. Now just click skip. Okay, now you have to make the username you're going to use to log in the system. So let me choose admin and admin. Okay, the username is admin. This is different from the root username. The root username is just like the super user of the Linux. It have the most privileges of the operating system. It can make anything remove files, make configurations to every user. Root is the super user. Okay, so I'll click Next. I will configure a password for the admin user. Okay, now click Next again. Okay, perfect. So the installation is ready. Let's click Start using AlmaLinux. Okay, so we are already inside the operating system, inside the graphical interface. AlmaLinux have a very nice, a very good looking interface. It's one of the best I have ever seen so far. If we talk about server-wide operating systems. So I'll click No Thanks. And that's it. It's ready. You can browse, you can work already. Open the applications. That's it. We are already using the Firefox on your graphical interface. You can click Activities to see more options, more desktops. This is the taskbar. More applications here. Okay, so thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the content, the video. Please like the content in YouTube and place a comment in this video. And also make sure to subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much. See you.